relations. Since the establishment of diplomatic relations, the bilateral relations between the two countries has been developing very well and will certainly continue to develop in the years to come. In forging the bilateral cooperation, since 15 May 1992, the government of the two countries have established a joint commission meeting. The last or sixth Indonesia-Suriname Joint Commission meeting was held virtually on 9 October 2021. Within this framework, the bilateral cooperation between Indonesia and Suriname is planned and detailed. However, it should be admitted that there are still shortcomings on the trade, tourism, and investment cooperation between the two countries. In 2019, the trade volume of both countries hit $9.2 million. Though during COVID-19 pandemic, the trade was declining to $5.8 million in 2020 and $4.3 million in 2021. In 2022, the trade volume between the two countries increased back to $5.8 million, and in 2023 was recorded at $6,398,000. Indonesian export to Suriname is only 0.0002% of the total Indonesian export to the global market, or 0.00318% of the total Suriname's import from the world market. If we look at this percentage, it is indeed very small. It is even more concerning that in the last several years, there have been no data recorded in the investment area of cooperation. However, in 2023, the Indonesian Investment Agency recorded Suriname's investment in Indonesia at $2.8 million. I'm confident that the spirit of friendship between the two countries will guide all stakeholders to find ways to enhance and strengthen relations on economic, trade, and investment. To improve the economic and trade trajectory between Indonesia and Suriname, as well as the countries in the region, Indonesian government holds the Indonesia, Latin America, and the Caribbean, or INALAM Business Forum and Trade Expo Indonesia on annual basis. The Embassy of Indonesia is now organizing and facilitating a number of Suriname's British businessmen to participate in the next INALAM Business Forum, which is to be held in Lima, Peru, on 11 to 13 September 2024, and Trade Expo Indonesia, which will be held in Jakarta on 9 to 12 October 2024. Indonesian Embassy is also planning to have Indofan again after 5 years absent in October 2024. The government of the Republic of Indonesia has also been developing bilateral cooperation on the capacity building in various areas. In the last several years, the government of Indonesia has offered scholarship to Suriname citizens for undergraduate as well as postgraduate degrees and will continue to offer in the years to come. The cooperation on capacity building could also be conducted by taking the benefit of the Indonesian Agency for International Development. In this regard, the Embassy of Indonesia and the relevant authorities of the government of Suriname could plan and design program for the capacity building in line with the needs of the government and people of the Republic of Suriname. Bilateral relations between Indonesia and Suriname has also been conducted through the engagement with CARICOM. Since the accreditation of the Indonesian ambassador in Paramaribo as the planning potential representative of the Republic of Indonesia to CARICOM in 2018, the Indonesia's engagement to CARICOM continues to grow. The government of the Republic of Indonesia offered an online training course on disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation for CARICOM member countries on August 8 to 12, 2022, and this training was continued with the capacity building on disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation to CARICOM member state in Bandung and Cirebon on 14 to 20 July 2023. Four Surinamers were recorded as active participants in this project. I have very reasonable conviction that the bilateral relations between the Republic of Indonesia and the Republic of Suriname will continue to develop. Suriname national as youth oil and gas reserves of soil and abundant natural resources. Once in production, the exploitation of these high-value resources will open multiple opportunities for further economic cooperation between the two countries. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I will not take more of your time. Hence, allow me to take this opportunity to convey my sincere appreciation and gratitude to the government as well as the people of the Republic of Suriname in supporting the Embassy of Indonesia to conduct its duties in Suriname. In closing, I would like to take this opportunity to extend my best wishes for the well-being and prosperity of the people of the Republic of Indonesia and the people of the Republic of Suriname under the good and eternal friendship between the government of the two countries. I thank you for your kind attention.